Guys, welcome to another video here on the channel. If you don't know me, hi, I'm Tite, and so today is the first episode of my series on this channel that is called Huge Room Makeover. So I started this makeover like 2 years ago or so, and I've never finished it because I just didn't have the time to. And so this summer I committed to it and I finished, and I'm so in love with the result, and I just wanted to share this with you. And so yeah, let's start. In this episode, I'm just going to talk about the concept, mood boards, and all the idea behind this project. As you can see, I've already did some changes here and I'm already showing you a part of this bedroom. I didn't plan to because I don't like want to spoil you, but yeah. So like any other project, the first thing that you want to do is to decide the budget, and so the budget that I had was 200 euros. I'm always saying dollars, that's why I just stopped there. 200 euros, and I could go up till 250. So the concept for this project was just to be as clean and as inspiring as it could get, and basically I think I did a really awesome job on that. Just fine. The concept was just inspired by Pinterest and Tumblr. The research was very important in this project because I wanted to spend the less money that I could, and also I wanted the best products. So it was just a lot of research, a lot of, you know, just going to stores, go to the websites, and just like mark everything that I wanted to buy and to just compare the prices and everything else. So here there are like the final list of the products that I wanted to buy, all the prices, and the final like result on the budget and everything, and also they're like organized with colors, and each color represents a store, so I could easily go to a store and get what I wanted and not like just rumble around and everything. Before going to stores and everything, while I was researching, I decided to do this book in which I would put all the process and like the mood boards, the color palettes and everything, because I wanted this project to be like a project of my decorating career. So in the first page, as you can see, I just wrote work number one because I intend to decorate more spaces and to just do more projects like this, and so this is where I'm going to put all the projects that I do. Then I just flip the page, and I didn't put anything here yet because I didn't want to spoil you that much on this video. So here's gonna be a photo of the final result. I just took the photo, and so just let me print and put it up here, but I didn't want to spoil you, and so that's why it's a blank space. Then I just print 4 pictures of the areas that I want to redecorate and do the makeover. And these are the pictures of my bedroom when I didn't know, I had no taste of fashion, design, aesthetics and everything. So it was not good. Moving on, 2 years ago I did like a makeover on this bedroom, but it was just a little makeover. I had the furniture moved here because I moved houses in Lisbon, and so the furniture that was in my old house just came to here because it didn't fit in my new bedroom because it's smaller, and so the furniture was here. And then I just did a little bit of details on other parts of this room and also painted all white, but you're gonna see that in the next video.
So on this page, I just put the photos of the bedroom 2 years ago, and ever since then, it was just this, until I, this summer, decided to do a makeover because I was just so tired of the bedroom. It was not comfortable, this room was not welcoming, and I just didn't feel at home, and so I had to change it. Then I just put the mood board of the color palette. So a mood board, I don't know if you know this, but a mood board is basically a page where you just put all the pictures, all the information that you want to get as an inspiration for your project. And so I did a lot of mood boards in this project, just be ready. So I chose this palette because it was the palette that I felt most comfortable with. The blacks and the grays are just amazing, they are very elegant, they are very comfy. Once put with gold and pink and with like green and the nature and everything, because the green just represents the plants that I have here. Then I have more two mood boards. So these mood boards are just with the details of each area that I was going to do my makeover. So I just have my wallpaper and like frames to put the pictures. Also fairy lights, clocks, plants, just basically basket. Just basically everything that I wanted to put in here. Then in the next mood board I have lamps, I have boxes, rugs, and also candles, more plants, because I like plants. Then I put an image of each division that I want to work on here, and then the specific elements for each division, with the price and also the shop where I could find them. And basically this was easier for me just to organize the space, organize my shopping. Then I did the same with the next area of this bedroom, and so I got, but yeah, this is like the desk area, the work area of this. So this is what the room looked like, and then this is what I wanted to put in this area. Then I had just a little areas that I want to work on. For the area that you're looking at, I just did the makeover of putting a gallery wall as well as this and the fairy lights and all this. But this is going to be in the next episode. When I was shopping, I just had two notebooks with me. There was the notebook where I just have everything planned, and also the notebook with all the prices, discounts and everything. Because when searching, I found out that I had discount codes and just discount, like student discount for specific stores, and so I had to just have a reminder. And so I just went shopping with these two notebooks, because here I had all the prices and the things that I really, really, really wanted to buy, and here just an inspiration. So if I saw anything that was in the list, but it was like cheaper or anything, I would just consult my notebooks, and so I would see if it was better to just buy another one. Welcome to another episode of the series of Huge Room Makeover. So in this episode I'm just going to be shopping. It's a vlog, so different style of video and everything. I just hope that you liked it as much as I did shopping. And so okay, so I just have the spray paintings that I wanted, gold and in black, and I also have a bunch of frames. I got two little ones, I got like one medium but more for like small size, then two mediums and two bigs. And the thing that I want to do is I wanted to like gallery wall with all the frames, and I shall see what turns out, because I'm just experimenting. You know, life is made out of experiences. Life lesson right there.
I'm trying to stop recording, but with one hand, it's difficult. Falling, dreaming, talking in your sleep. I know you want to cry all night. Plotting, scheming, finding reason to defend all of your violent nights.
So right now we are at IKEA because I have to buy all the things for my bedroom. I don't know if you can hear me, but yeah. And we are eating because we are starving. And basically that's it. Just looking for the rest of the decorations that we have to get. And yep. I hope you guys liked it, and be excited for next week's episode because it's going to be the start of something new. It feels so right to be here with you. Oh. It's going to be the start of the real room makeover, like, thingy. And I hope you really liked this video, and if you did, just give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel, please. And turn the notifications on if you want to be alert whenever I post a video, because I want to post more here, but I just needed a time to edit, to just do something that I really, really like and I'm proud of. And yeah, I hope you guys liked it, and see you in the next video. Bye!